Huge bodywork damage together with structural damage, no doubt. This is the onboard. Nasty. So race number 27, there is the aftermath of the incident. So the right front and right rear are completely missing from that car.
One of the best parts about living on the Gold Coast is the GC600. I feel like I've done this before.
Ready to go down and vlog a little bit down on the track?
Oh, wait.
Yep. Got my camera on ready.
Oh, excellent. Yep. It's good to see you focused.
Oh,
it's a camera off you want,
okay.
Is it? It's a camera off.
Are you
right.
Going?
All right, well, yeah, I can zoom too.
You ready to log the race now?
What? I can't hear you.
Trying to get that shot of that chopper.
Vlog life!
Caleb goes, oh, I think the cars are starting. And then it just turned out we were walking past a generator.
Yeah.
It was like the hum of a fridge. It wasn't even remotely on a car level. So we spent a little too long vlogging during the race, and now the jet's about to come over, and I want to be up top, well, up top of the building to get a good view of the jet. And the good camera's dead. Oh. We made it. I think the jet goes over in like 2 minutes. We've got time. Oh, my keys. The fighter jet's always my favorite part of the race every year.
This takes so long, though.
How you feeling?
Fit? Fine. Yeah, fit. We ran across the entire track.
I'm just in my office because it's a little bit loud out there, as you can imagine when living on a racetrack. The GC600 gets beamed to 96 countries, 230 million homes, and 200,000 people have flooded in for the 2019 race weekend. But as incredible as the race is, whether you're into cars or not, it's not as incredible as the fighter jet. So in memory of the fighter jet that's not appearing this year, apparently, here's a look back at previous years.